It's time. Finally, it's time for my pretty much my favorite game of the year in N64 1997. It's Diddy Kong Racing Time. I have the box. I have the magazine with Diddy Kong Racing, and I have three fucking guides for it. Three guides. I have Prima, Brady Games, and the one that doesn't look like a piece of garbage, Official Nintendo Powers Player Guide. Fantastic. Awesome. Ready to go. I will probably need those for tips at some point in the future, but honestly, I have no problems just jumping right into this game because I know the gist of things and just check real quick. Options, of course, you know, of my Diddy Kong Racing shirt that Honest Gamer Mike's financier.
Diddy Kong Racing!
Janelle made for me.
Hey, it's TikTok!
So, it's not set in stone, but really, I think that the lighter characters usually are better. I'm gonna leave that there and just start game B as my new game. And yeah, it's from my one file from before. And so I was reading in the Nintendo Power Players guide. Apparently the story for Diddy Kong Racing, which we're gonna kind of get here. I don't really think they do a full thing. I don't remember it, at least. But the idea is that Timber, the tiger, his parents are away visiting the Kongs in Jungle Japes, whatever the hell you want to call it, that they live in. And he races as a hobby, and, like, this is where Timber lives. And Whizpig comes and invades and decides that, you know, he's running shit now, and he wants to get people to challenge him for their racing capabilities.
I'm the genie of the island. I'm here to help you. Good luck.
Dodge. He's great. Yeah, there's really no story there. It's apparently, so Timber's parents were away, Whizpig invaded while they were away, and said, hey, I heard that you guys race real good, so I'm not leaving until someone beats me in a race. And that's the gist of it. So Timber calls up all his friends, including Banjo and Conker, Diddy, Tip Top Pipsy, and even Crunch, the Kremling, to come and help him. And Drumstick the Chicken. If anybody knows Drumstick the Chicken already at this point, he was the first person to kind of go and try and beat him. So that's why he's an unlockable character along with Taj and TZ. But no problems here, just jumping right into it. Get ready for Ancient Lake. And we have our first amazing music track of the game. It's just so catchy. You don't even need power slides on this track, it's just crazy. It's such a easy first track. You get into it and you feel like you're gonna be challenged by it. Like, oh god, I hope I don't mess this up, but I mean, this is the easiest track in the game for sure. Especially at this point, so don't get too fancy or anything. I already have the three missiles lined up, so that's cool. I don't really need them. Big old dino. This is such a short track too. We're on a third lap. It's like a 25 second lap. So this is probably a good time to explain the, you know what? Fire fucking everything. It's a good time to explain the layout of the game. It's a really, really deep game. It's based, you know, if you didn't know already, it's based on sort of the adventure style that the N64 would end up doing really, really well. By the end of its lifetime. Banjo-Kazooie, all these other rare games, Zelda, Mario, Collectathon, stuff like that. And the format, like you saw, I drive around, I have free roam over the island at this point. And you always have free roam over the island. and you go and you enter whatever race is available to you at the time, and you conquer that race. But it goes with a certain format, so you see these are the gold balloon races. That's the first time you race on a course, is the gold balloon ones. And then after that, once you've gotten the gold balloon from each of the races in an area, basically, this is Dino Domain, then you can take on the boss for the first time. After that, you step into the realm of the silver coin challenges for each world, where you not only have to win the race, but you have to collect all the silver coins on the track before you finish the race. So like your victory doesn't count unless you've gotten all the silver coins, because then they'll give you another gold coin, another gold balloon. They'll give you another gold balloon, and then you get to go take on the boss a second time. Well, there will be harder. And then at that point, you get a piece of the amulet, which opens up the big, scary pig face on the side of the mountain. And you get to take on Whizpig. And there's just so much depth in this game that even that is really only scratching the surface as to, like, what you're responsible for doing in this game if you want to, say, like, complete it. This is a game I've never completed in my life. But I have beaten it several times, including on the DS version. I've beaten Whizpig, just the like, final boss version of Whizpig. Trying to think if I've beaten them both times. There's two Whizpig fights, Whizpig races. I'm not sure if I've done that, but... I have not even come close to really completing the game. But I have, I've beaten Whizpig several times in my life. So I don't know if I'm about to embark on that, that particular way. I mean, it would take up so much time to really complete the game. But, you know, with this being the big project, where I want to go play every game, this is one of the first games I can see myself going back to and really completing it and really... So obviously I'm going to beat the game at this point, but I don't actually know just how far I want to take that definition, which is fine. I can't spend too much time, but I will spend, you know, a full week playing this for myself, because it's, like I said, it's one of my favorite games on the system. There we go, finally got that. And not only do I have the sort of the drive to... Oh, I done goofed. Restart. Not only do I sort of have the drive to complete the game at some point, I mean, I have the guides, too, to tell me. I don't really need the strategies necessarily, but, you know, you do kind of want to make sure you don't get lost. Make sure you figure out what you're doing. Basically this bridge is going to make sure that you're approaching it the right way, because the elevation keeps you from being able to see where you're supposed to cross. Take that shield and just go for this. I did learn one seemingly very important tip just by kind of perusing the Nintendo Power Player's Guide, which is that to take full advantage of the zippers, basically, the little speed boost things that are lying on the ground there, like this, you should take your thumb off of the accelerate button, and just get into the rhythm of, I'm literally right about to go over one of these things, lift your thumb up, see, I didn't do it that time, but you can see the difference, I don't think I did that correctly that time. There's one in this mouth. Yeah, just... you can see the green is when I'm getting the better boost. Whereas the purple is when I still have my thumb down. So we are cruising through this shit. Because, like, it's... So... Like, that one. Alright, we go back outside and have a look around, basically. We'll go find Taj, because he should be doing a Taj challenge, I assume. Hi, Taj.
Hello, friend. Bye-bye for now.
Have a good look around, because I forget what you have to do to get yourself sort of at the jumping off point. Go back in here. Trophy race. Ah. Oh. How long has it been since I've actually started a new game on this? TT?
Hi there, I'm TT.
No, that's fine.
Okay.
Challenge. Oh, you know what? You can just go to. I think I can go to, whatever the fuck it's called. Snow Peak Mountain and do one of those races, because I think you only need so many balloons. But I need a plane for that.
Hello, friend. Select your vehicle. Abracadabra.
Thank you, sir.
Can I help you?
Bye-bye for now. I'm good. And now we're in the plane. Fun stuff. Yeah, 2 golden balloons to get in here, so.
Snowflake.
Yep. So I can do this one, and I can do Walrus Cove right away. And then go back to Dino Domain, take on the boss. Awesome. And we in the plane. Nice. And another interesting thing that I learned from using the Nintendo Power Guide. No, you're not getting that. Two things actually. Now that I'm thinking about it, because I'm playing. So the difference between the Road Zippers and the hovercraft and plane ones is that the Road Zippers will get you going on whatever direction you're facing. So you can point like. At like a 45 degree angle to what you're, to like the zipper that you're going across, and it'll just shoot you directly in the direction that you're facing at the time. However, the hovercraft and plane zippers, the ones that are in the air or floating on the water, those will actually point you in the direction that they're facing. So there's a big difference between those. Also. Important tip, I may have remembered this when I, like, learned to do this when I was a kid, but I didn't remember this going into it. Flying the planes, all the plane races, are best undertaken with the sort of power steering thing that you get by holding down the R button. Because this is me steering without that, and that's me steering with it. So, it's just, because it's not like you have to take these huge wide turns, you really just want to turn the plane as soon as you can. And I also have to remember to take my thumb off the accelerator every time I hit a zipper. There you go. Taking first. I took first, right? Good. And up. And same applies for when you get the pickup, the blue balloon pickups, and you have a boost to go with that. You can take your thumb off the accelerator, hit the boost button, and then put it right back on. It's pretty great. Good tip to know. tips to know for flying the planes, tips to know for using the boosts, tips to know for being effective with everything like that. And let's do Walrus Cove. So we'll just hit this one and then go back over to Dino Domain, do the last race, and then race Tricky, and I think that'll about wrap it up, because I really just want to entrench myself in this goddamn game, because I love it so much. So I'll play this, like, the rest of the afternoon. But, I do a lot of streaming, so I like to just sit back and relax with this game, to be honest with you. I think there's also a timing thing that factors in when you do the boost, where you have to wait until the boost is kind of like dying out to put your thumb back on the accelerator, because it'll kind of choke it off, basically, what it seems like. But I think that's what they said in the Nintendo Power Guide, and I'm starting to see it just on that one that I used it right there, so I have to test it out a little bit more. Shields as soon as I get them, because I want to actually get boosts and weapons. Boosts and missiles are the most important thing for me, honestly. Just, it seems very rare that, at this stage at least, that the other characters are actually getting weapons and stuff. How the hell are y'all getting in front of me? Oh, and just for the record, the bananas, they're kind of like the coins in Mario Kart, or at least the way that they have them now, where it increases your top speed the more bananas that you pick up. So you lose bananas when you get hit, just like in Mario Kart lately, but you do get a slight boost on your top speed when you do it. I wonder if that boost right there going around that loop-de-loop works the same way. Finally have more than a single pickup booster. See how it works and if I can pull it off right. Oh, did I really not get my thumb off the accelerator that time? That seemed like I did. There we go. Oh lord. That's okay. If anybody gets in front of me, I just pop them with the missile right away. But I got this. Woo! Here you go, tip top. Top of the pop, tippity tip. That's my boy. That is my boy. So going especially by the ones, basically what they say about all the guys and what you can see when you play the game. Characters that are good in cars and planes are usually the light ones, the lightest characters, like Tip Top, Pipsy, and then going down the line, Diddy Kong, Timber, and Bumper. Ooh, Toss Challenge? Yeah! Let's do this. They're good in cars and planes because they give the best, handling without sacrifice. I mean, the heavier cars have the best top speed in, heavier characters have the best top speed in hovercraft, in cars, and the opposite is true for the hovercrafts. Which is on the water. And the heavier characters, they also get their better handling and such out of the hovercraft because they're weighing it down more. So they're weighing it down, but they can't go as fast. That's easy.
Hello, friend.
I forget, do you give me a balloon?
Bye-bye for now.
Is it a balloon or is it a... Yes, it's a balloon. Awesome. It's so much. It's predating fucking Banjo-Kazooie and shit by making me collect things all the time. So, it's just like, does he give me a balloon or does he give me a coin or what the fuck? Because you gotta get the balloons, then you're racing, you gotta get the coins. The coins get you another balloon. It all works out when you're playing the game. But if I'm trying to explain it to people, it's like the same as trying to explain Banjo-Kazooie. It's like, yeah, you have to get puzzle pieces and notes and Jinjos and Donkey Kong, you have to get 50 different things, and just, it's a lot better when you play it because You don't have to learn it all at once. Oh my god, the music in this game is fucking amazing. That's a good good little like double tap of the boost when you get those two zippers right there, right after the other. Because you don't even have to put your thumb back on the accelerator, it just missed it by a smidge at that time. But yeah, really the key to winning at this game is being able to take advantage of shit like that. Oh yeah, that was it. I fucking hit the ceiling. It's alright though. Yeah, this is awesome. There's like seriously no point in me getting 10 missiles when I'm in front. And I like hang on to them when I could just be grabbing boost balloons. Just for that little bit, tiny extra push. Right over your head. Oh shit, I missed that one because I was pointing down. And take my thumb off that. There we go. Alright. It's time to face Tricky the Triceratops, which is funny. Because I'm pretty sure that Prince Tricky is the name of the dinosaur in Star Fox Adventures. So I guess that's a thing that Rare did, that they named their characters that way. Just a thought. They have two Triceratops named Tricky, partly because of their the letters that make up the name. Not a bad name for a game like this, to point it out. Honestly, it fits here better than it fits in Star Fox Adventure, which would have been Dinosaur Planet. Just doesn't seem right. Star Fox Adventure and Dinosaur Planet is a little bit more mature, so characters named Tricky even though he's a little kid. Yeah! Fuck you. I think I have this track on my iPhone, honestly. It's so upbeat and so, like, this is racing me. There you go. That little quick boost right by him. Like, as the track gets narrower, you get paranoid. Oh my god, like, is he gonna come right up behind me? Because he'll run right over me. I saw that. Damn. So that I can grab that boost balloon as I flew by it. Ooh, now he might catch up. Ah! Ooh, just missed it. Awesome. Just a little bit more. Maybe not just a little bit, but still. Oh no! Fuck. God damn it. It's like the Alcatraz track in San Francisco Rush. It's so crushing it can fall off. That balloon. Pass in front of me, I don't care. Shoot. Fuck! I missed him. Oh, fuck you. Better. We're back up on his tail. Honestly, I'd rather stay on his tail the entire time and pull out right at the end. Because you can't do shit like that. How am I supposed to pass him when we're on this narrow ass hill? It just keeps getting narrower and narrower. And boosting can really fuck you over too. Like I did last time. Wanted a little bit too much. Oh my! Really? That's some bullshit right there. Fine. No more boosting. Not as much boosting. Trying to fucking take off. Stop it! Asshole. I have a homing missile on you. Yeah, fuck you. Stop! That's... Just like he's the first boss! Oh, I missed him. Maybe I'll save it up for like one boost and hopefully I'll just blow right by him. Yes, just save it. Or don't try, or don't pull your thumb off the accelerator. Don't get too ahead of yourself. Probably still be too much at this point. Yep, I blew it, because there's no way I was gonna pass him that time. Alright, come on. Right ahead, because I'll hit you with this one. Just take the quicker track. Try and stay on the inside and don't get too ahead of myself. Let's get to the point where you feel like you need that. Yeah, it's just a real little short burst, so you can do just a single one and not get it full force. Best way to do it. You might need to get a little bit more serious about it next time you race, but just that little tiny kick actually seems like it helps you a lot. Here we go! Final! It's like five tries. Ridiculous. Alright. Yeah! Silver coin challenge!
Silver coins from around the dino domain.
Yep.
You must find 8 from each level and win.
And there's the rules. At least they told you that in the game, which is actually not something that most games would do for you. So.
I got something special for you.
Yes? Yeah, I know. That's cool. That's not really something special.
Here's something special.
So yeah, the next thing is we can do any of these three races here, and then by then, I'll be able to do Hot Top Volcano again. So, yep, that's cool. And, yeah, got started on Diddy Kong. There will be more videos of this to come. But, absolutely fantastic game. Very excited. Just gonna get into it right now. Thanks for watching. I'll be back shortly over the weekend, whatever, when I do. See you later.